pretty much, my mom was a Christian and she always would make us go to church. I basically just started kind of turning my own way. I just wanted to do things my own way. By the time I was 14, I was getting into drugs. I was drinking. I was trying to get attention from guys all the time, and I just really despised myself. After I graduated high school, I moved to New York City and had that freedom of being by myself on my own, and I just started to get really more heavy into drugs and everything. Basically, I was looking in all these other places and asking other people for help, but you know, the only person that could have helped me or saved me was Jesus. And I started praying at night. I was like, if you're real, God, then you will make me not want to smoke cigarettes. You'll make me not want to do drugs. You'll make me not want to drink anymore. You'll make me stop doing these things if you're real. You know, I was really suicidal as well. Like, I was cutting myself and just at my lowest low. And one day in March of 2007, I woke up and I didn't want anything. I didn't want to do anything like that anymore. God had answered my prayer and he took all of those desires away from me. Just, it was amazing and it really was a miracle. And I can't even explain it. I didn't want anything to do with any of that stuff. So I moved back to Ohio after that. After I moved back, I never even thanked God for answering my prayer. I never gave him glory. I never even turned to him. I kept turning my own way. I just kept shutting him out, even though he had saved me from all this stuff. I thought, well, maybe I did that on my own. And I basically was believing all these lies from the enemy that I did this on my own and, you know, I don't need God. You know, my depression never really went away. It got a little bit better because I wasn't doing a lot of drugs and stuff, but I still had all those thoughts of suicide and just hatred towards myself. But then I got married to Ricky in 2009, February, and 1 month after our wedding, my husband's best friend got in a motorcycle accident and died. And it really shook us up. Neither one of us were Christians, and we didn't know how to cope with that. So we turned to alcohol, and we were drinking like every night because it was our way of killing the pain. I thought that I could do it on my own, but since my feet weren't on solid rock, it's just everything came crumbling back down again. I was like a clean house, like a clean slate. I didn't have God to replace all of those old habits, so instead, all these other demons came back in. I had all these horrible thoughts in my head all the time that, you know, people hated me and I wasn't worth it, and what was the point of life? I should just kill myself. I didn't know what else to do, and probably around early fall, late summer of 2009, the same year we got married, I was just curious, you know, about the Bible. And I was thinking, like, you know, I've tried all these other religions and for some reason they're just not working, so I guess I'll try this one. My husband and I got into an argument and I went to bed and I just had a horrible nightmare that Satan was standing over my bed, choking me and asking me, do you believe in God? And I said, yeah. And he just continued to choke me and my husband, and I was just thrashing all over the place. And my husband woke me up and said, you just had a nightmare, just go back to bed. I knew at that moment what it was, because I had experienced things like that in the past, and I just knew it was pure evil. And I don't know how much time passed, but all of a sudden I could smell something burning. Something wasn't right. And the next thing I knew, I was just sitting straight up and I was screaming at the top of my lungs. And I could feel, it felt like a hand just reaching down my throat. And I just like was like, no, no. And I knew that I had to fight, and I had to read God's word and just know how to fight all of this away from me, because it was just, it was gonna keep me from having that relationship with Jesus. So my husband was like, everything's fine, nothing's here. And I asked him, will you pray with me? And we just sat there and prayed, which was the first time ever. I mean, because we never ever prayed together, but we just said, you know, Jesus, you're the only one that can save us from this, you know. So will you just come into our hearts and just help us to fight whatever is here and keep us safe, you know. I prayed constantly. I felt myself growing closer and closer with God, and it was just amazing. You know, there's no other way. Now I'm just continuing to walk with Jesus, and that's what he had been knocking on my door about this whole time. My name is Kelsey Williams, and God gave me a second chance.